Good afternoon.
The puppet dies.
Oh, thank you and good afternoon.
Hello. Welcome to the Stoughton Bottle. We've even got the album artwork and everything. So basically you're going to get more or less the CD version of the album, the reissue, with a couple of extras thrown in that we might have played at the time. This is In the End.
Twilight hanging on the edge of night.
Thank you very much in the end. Hope it's all balancing up okay out there.
Yeah, we're good.
Hope the wrong notes weren't coming through too loud and clear.
So this is where we diverge from the original album. And on the CD version, we stuck an extra song in and we moved this song to here. This is In the Universe.
Actually, it was the cassette version that we first made that change.
Oh, was that so we could fit a B-side on or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, we moved in the universe from side two of the LP to side one of the cassette. So yeah, so we could fit the B-side of the single on side two. Yeah. This one we've done a few acoustic versions of, but we hardly ever played it anything like it was recorded.
Two twin necks, so he's got to be prog. This is In the Universe.
Ourselves in this universe.
much in the universe.
If you go into a bar, I'll have a bag of crisps, love.
Yeah, it was a kind of funny album, Stoughton Bottle. It's kind of, we'd been on a bit of a roll. We'd done the Cellar Tapes, we'd done Cellar V, we'd done the Ember 12-inch single, we'd done the Cellar Replay tape. We were playing like every night of every week of every year for quite a while. And it seemed to be going quite well. And then we started recording Stoughton Bottle. We'd got as far as the single Tunnel Vision, and we got that out.
Then we set off.
But we hadn't got the album finished in time for the September tour of 86, so we set off on tour and never got there.
1st of October 1986, on the way to Southampton. We were in an ambulance with a trailer on the back, and a Volvo on the opposite lane of the A34 near Oxford decided to cross the central reservation in front of us. We survived.
Just about. We were back on the road by Christmas, to be honest, and then we got the album. We went back to recording the album after that and got it out in 87. But by that point, Pinnacle Records, who were distributing for us, had gone into receivership, and the new company who'd taken them over was basically ditching all the small, uneconomical labels like us. So after having distribution on stuff we'd done before, Stoughton Bottle, which probably in a lot of ways was the best recording we did in the 80s, kind of never quite got the distribution that the other stuff did.
It's a great bass sound on Stoughton Bottle. I mean, I'm not showing off and not proud of anything else I ever recorded, but the bass sounds overall on the album were all right.
We'll delve into that more. But this was a little showcase for Paul Chisnell. Actually, this was going to be... Weren't we going to write a follow-up to The Hum?
The Hum Part 2, yes, I was thinking about that the other day. One of each of the black and brown moles survived, one male, one female. Bred and took over the world.
A new race of super moles.
Yeah, it was the version where the human race lost. But what was left of that ended up as a song epitaph, which we'll come to in a fortnight or 4 weeks or whatever it is.
And so this was kind of, a little bit of a riff that was going to go that way. And there's hints of The Hum in it. And it kind of turned into a drum solo.
Which we're going to do a drum machine solo. We were also ahead of our time. This could be a first.
This is an edited version.
Featuring drum machine solo. Humbug.
Oh!
And that was mostly the Vice. Yeah, it wasn't a... I know it had sort of... It had the makings of concept album, the Stoke and Bottle, with the sort of the pub theme and the intro song, but in reality, there were probably only a couple of songs on the album that actually fitted the concept. The rest of them were kind of just songs. Stoke and Bottle, obviously, the intro song, sets the scene. I think Fading Away was fairly obviously set in the pub, as was Resealing, the intro to Tunnel Vision, and of course the finale. This was probably the only other one that was the scenario was your local pub.
Yeah, this is the old guy in the corner. This is
Chilling.
Just one more question to ask before I break down and cry. Oh, my love, why did you have to die? Why did you have to die? Why did you have to die? Why did you have to die?
Autumn, and that is the end of side one. Or it was on the LP and cassette, anyway.
Now then, before we get on to side two, shortly after Stone Bottle, we kind of wrote a whole other album that kind of never got kind of recorded properly as such. Some of it surfaced in live gigs, some of it surfaced as the Hayes World Turtle CD that we'll come to in a fortnight. This one never quite surfaced.
Yeah, there's Paul perhaps didn't give you the full story when he said we were pretty much doing the CD. The CD did have a lot of bonus tracks on the end of it, which are actually, they were demos that were recorded after Stone Bottle. Yeah, demos for what would have been the next album. But because basically they ended up on the World Turtle Tree Beer, the World Turtle Haze album, which is the next one we're going to come to, we thought we'll give you the full version of those then. So this is, this is the interval song. This one, we used to use it as an opener, I think, in the late days.
Yeah, 10th anniversary opening, remember this one.
But never recorded, no studio version of it ever done. This one's called Into the Fire.
Yeah.
molten flesh, the pools of petrol sweat. Heat, danger, but if we fail, ash, embers, tell the tale. Strike a spark, let it feed the fire. Strike a spark and the flames grow higher. Tonight, tonight. Whoa, into the fire we go.
Into the fire.
So on to side two. This is one of those little extra bits that we added on to the song. Are we having problems there? Oh dear, it looks like we may not have a backup recording of this. But yeah, this one is kind of, let's be honest, it's an instrumental version of The Ceiling's Coming Down as played by an imaginary pub band in the Stone. Oh. Right, where were we?
I've no idea.
So, resealing.
Contradiction.
Thank you very much. Tunnel Vision, that was... we recorded that as a single in late 86 and then re-recorded it for the album in 87. It was a slightly extended version of the album, which is what we did then. Right, oh, we've got a few proper prog songs coming up. These were...
This one's Ophelia. He's just done something terrible, he says. Right. He's probably erased all the drum programs now or something. Why am I not inspired with confidence? Anyway, we're going to push the button and hope to God that the electronic drummer plays Ophelia.
Thank you. Oh,
fantastic.
And that was the B-side of the Tunnel Vision single. There's also another version of that song, Shadows, that went out on the Fire in Harmony album, which was, yeah, it's the only album we've ever been on that charted.
Number 49 in the Kerrang chart, yes, which you'll never forget. I was passed a question by Kat about Tunnel Vision, why sometimes the chorus contains the words black box in it. That was the sort of alien Shaw World Turtle rewrite of Tunnel Vision, where I was playing guitar, we had a separate bass player, or an automated bass player. And we did the song with a rewritten chorus that just went black box, Tunnel Vision. And that's where the, you know, it's a dangerous religion line came from, which was never on the Stoke bottle. I didn't realise that.
Ah, no, I'd forgotten that too. No.
You know, when you tell us we're playing these things, I go home and listen to them. Silly me. So I hope that explains it. It was a different version of the song played by a different band that was still me and him.
Which actually, that version never got recorded, did it? Maybe on a demo?
There's a demo with Sam Carr, the drummer, singing backing vocals on it as well.
Ooh. Shall I put it up on Reverb?
If you can find it, it's around somewhere, yeah.
Shall I put it on Bandcamp?
When we have sort of Pete playing bass and Sam Carr on drums.
Actually, yeah, I've only just put this album, Stoke and Bottle, up on Bandcamp. So
You've got a wardrobe full of the CDs,
I've got
haven't you?
I thought I didn't want to start sort of selling downloads when I've got lots of actual CDs to get rid of. But then Bandcamp are getting really good now. You can also sell real physical merchandise through them, as well as downloads, and they don't take too much. So it's I thought it's worth putting up. So thank you very much, everyone who has chipped in and ordered one. I've got them all. I've got all my labels printed out upstairs. I'll be posting them off right after this session.
It's us that do it, you know. I think sometimes you may think there's a huge crew of people. You know, we stick them on, and me and my daughter's going to stick them through the postbox at the bottom of the road. This is a cottage industry, people.
Yeah, and also we've got the original artwork from Stoat and Bottle. This was the painting that was done. Actually, it was Samantha Jones, my partner, my girlfriend at the time, her mum, Brenda Jones, painted this for us. And this is the original painting done way back in 1987.
86 or 87,
possibly,
yeah.
86. Have a close look at this.
Here it comes. Oh, it's gone all black. You can see that. Yeah. It's photos of us, by the way. And Ben the dog down there when he was a puppy.
Yeah, it's all painting, and then we're just stuck on it, photoshopped in before it was even invented. Right, let's rumble on with this.
A scalpel and some glue.
Yeah.
Well, let's not say too much about it. They don't like this one, do they? Let's just get it over and done with.
I don't know. Who doesn't like this one?
No.
I don't know. I think
they came up on the request show. And even Roger's Revenge did that.
maybe they were just joking.
It does, however, contain a career summary in one line, flogging a dark horse down a dead-end street.
Living in hope.
your heart fighting the stream. Take the easy way, you know what I mean. Just turn around and go with the flow. If it drags you down, that's the way it goes. Still got some beer in the tunnel, you know, where we did an acoustic gig. I use that for chilling beer in when we're not playing there. In fact, we ought to turn this place into the Stoughton Bottle, have a bar, have if we drill through the wall just behind the camera, if you drill about 3 feet that way, you're into the tunnel. Yeah, good work.
Yeah. Are you the barman then?
I shall be the head brewer. Yeah. And you can drink whatever I don't.
Right, this brings us nicely to the end of the album, to the end of the Stoughton Bottles LP, with a very appropriate Last Orders, please. Thank you very much. Last orders, please.
Thank you. Get back behind bar cat. Yeah, Moa. Can you do us a whoop? Dave Hadley did a whoop.
Whoop.
That's the one. Thank you.
Whoop. Whoop. That's the one, isn't it? Yeah. Whoop. Yeah, we're... So, as we said earlier, we're not going to do all the extras from the CD, because they're all on the World Turtle CD, which is coming in 2 weeks' time. So do stick around for that. So that'll be same place, same time, and we'll be going through the whole of our... It was our first CD of new material, actually, because In the End came out in 91-ish, I think, and that was just a retrospective old recording, but the World Turtle Hazel was the first... one of actually new recordings for CD, so it was kind of our first proper CD. So that's the next session. So we thought instead we were digging around, listening to all real recordings. John Morby engaged on the absolute epic task of digitising 150 live cassettes that I'd got still stored down in the cellar here from like the 1980s, and he digitised them all and put them on a drive for me. So I was looking through them thinking, oh, what did we used to play back then? And we used to play some, well, right, old stuff, really. And this is a...
We were trying to entertain you. I don't know if you realised this. If we did a Frankie Goes to Hollywood song, we were trying to entertain. And something, you know, from the charts and Nelly the Elephant at Christmas.
Oh, bloody hell, yeah, I remember that. But this is one that we did do a studio recording, although I don't think it appeared on any proper albums. I think it appeared on the Peterborough tapes of all things.
I remember... I worked all this out in my head when we were extras on the Princess Bride film. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Days on Film, where us and Tim got the part of playing extras when they were filming quite a good film called Princess Bride out in Derbyshire.
You should check it out. It's fabulous there.
And as I was there, sort of standing there all day, being paid to stand there all day, thinking, my God, the work we used to do for nothing. This was going through my head. I thought, that song can be fitted to that riff and we can do this, and this is it. It was a one-hit wonder from the 60s, Thunderclap Newman.
Yeah.
Something in the Air.
The 60s social revolution. Where did that one go wrong?
I think that song's quite appropriate, really, isn't it?
Should we try again?
All right, if you want to go home for your tea now, that's fine. This is one of those things that we've kind of... Whenever we've needed something like really ridiculously simple to play that lots of people can join in with, this has been it. And I must have done
National
this.
Chopper Club, 1986.
Oof.
Yeah, we were playing to a load of bikers playing prog rock and stuff. Yeah, see, you've moved beyond that, lads. Would you mind playing us some rock and roll that we can dance to? And this is 7 foot bikers and there's 500 of them. Do anything with a country twang, so we thought if this ever happens to us again, we'll just do this.
Thank you.
Yeah, oh really, is it?
Well, yes, they've all switched off. In case you haven't, see you next week for Lord Knows What, and the week after for the World Turtle Hay CD.
Yay!
I'll go and put these guitars away and get some others out.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in, folks. Good to see you all again. And yeah, see you soon.